Hey guys, this is Saurabh Nahai from AllAboutTechnologies, and in this video, let's do a quick battery drain test between the Poco F1 and the Redmi Note 5 Pro, since both the devices have 4000mAh battery, and on the extreme left, we have a timer, so we will check for how much time both the devices can actually last, and watch it till the end because it's gonna be interesting. Also guys, by the time I was setting up my camera after booting up the devices, battery on the Poco F1 already dropped by 1%, so it's on 99%, whereas Redmi Note 5 Pro is still on 100%, so that's making the video already interesting. Anyways, let's start off with AnTuTu benchmarks and see the scores as well as battery drop. Also, please hit that like button since these tests, they take almost 8 to 9 hours to just shoot, so do show some love. So after approx 9 minutes, scores are here, and let's close the application and check the battery drop on both the devices. So battery on the Redmi Note 5 Pro is on 98%, whereas it's 97% on the Poco F1, which is 2% drop on both the devices. Anyways, let's run the test for 3 more times and check the battery drop. So finally, after running the AnTuTu test for 4 times, scores are here, and let's close the application on both the devices and check the battery drop after approx 35 minutes. So the battery on the Redmi Note 5 Pro is on 92%, whereas on the Poco F1 it's on 89%. So as you can see, the difference has started increasing, but to be honest, it's not that huge. Now let's move on to Geekbench 4 and let's see the scores of both the devices. After approx 5 minutes, scores are here for those who are interested. I will run this test for 3 more times and then we will check the battery drop. So after running Geekbench test for 4 times, scores are here. Let me close the application and let's check the battery drop. So the battery on the Redmi Note 5 Pro is at 90%, whereas it's 84% on the Poco F1, which means there is a difference of around 6% now. Anyways, it's time to run PUBG Mobile on training mode since we all play PUBG for 1 hour at least. So let's see how much that will consume battery. 1 hour later, it's time to close PUBG and check the battery drop on both the smartphones. So the battery has dropped to 76% on the Redmi Note 5 Pro from 90%, whereas it's on 70% on the Poco F1 from 84%. So approx 14% drop on both the smartphones. Now it's time to play YouTube videos for 2 hours since we all watch YouTube a lot. So let's see how much battery it will eat. Hours later, we are into the test for 4 hours and battery on the Redmi Note 5 Pro is at 55%, whereas it's 47% on the Poco F1. It's time to move on to camera application now for 30 minutes. I started recording 1080p videos since 4K video support is still not available for the Redmi Note 5 Pro. Anyways, after 15 minutes, I started recording from the front camera. 30 minutes later, it's time to stop recording and close the application to check the battery drop. So the battery on the Redmi Note 5 Pro is at 46%, whereas it's 38% on the Poco F1, which is still 8% difference. Anyways, it's time for the Instagram application since this is also one of the applications that a lot of people use 1 to 2 hours daily. So let's see how much this will consume battery on both devices. Also, we will see if the difference between the two increases or not. One hour and 30 minutes later, it's time to close the Instagram application and check the battery drop. So the Redmi Note 5 Pro is on 31% now, whereas the Poco F1 is on 21%, which means the drop has further increased by 2% on the Poco F1, making the total difference of 10%. Time to run Asphalt 8 now till both the devices drain completely. So at 7 hours and 10 minutes, battery on the Poco F1 has reached to 1%, whereas it's still on 13% on the Redmi Note 5 Pro. Finally, at 7 hours and 13 minutes, Poco F1 gave up, which is an awesome timing for a flagship-like product. Whereas Redmi Note 5 Pro still has 12% battery left. Let's see how much more time it will last and what will be the final difference between the two. Redmi Note 5 Pro finally gave up at 7 hours and 53 minutes, which is 40 minutes more than the Poco F1. Now, even though both of them have 4000mAh battery, display is a bit bigger on the Poco F1 at 6.18 inches and it's just 5.99 inches on the Redmi Note 5 Pro. Apart from this, processor is different on both the devices, obviously, and Poco F1 is a fairly newer device compared to 7-8 months old Redmi Note 5 Pro. So the battery optimization can also get better on the Poco F1. That said, I still love the battery on the Poco F1 because I could play PUBG on high graphics without worrying much about battery. So guys, let me know your thoughts in the comment section. Anyways, that was the test which took 8 to 9 hours. So if you enjoyed it, please do give this video a like as it will motivate me to bring more such amazing test videos for you guys. If you're new here, make sure to subscribe and turn on the notifications because only then you will get notified about such amazing test videos. So please hit that subscribe button and turn on the notifications. And if you're interested in buying any of the devices, links will be there in the description box. Do use my link, that will definitely help out the channel. That's it guys, this is Saurabh Nahar. Thank you guys for watching, bye.